should be played at high volume, preferably in a residential area.
Clinger. Clinger. Is that it? The rifle makes me nervous. Actually, the purse does too. Just sit down and take a load off your heels. What's your problem, which I may have tattooed on my forehead?
Got this a mail call today, sir.
What is it?
A letter from my mother. Dear son,
you obviously haven't sent her a recent picture.
Sir, please. We know your colonel has a good heart. And surely he'll let you come home for your father's funeral. Or his 65th birthday, whichever comes first.
Uh-huh. Here we go. The father dying, right?
Yes, sir.
Father dying last year. Mother dying last year. Mother and father dying. Mother, father, and older sister dying. Mother dying and older sister pregnant. Here's an oldie, but a goodie. Half of the family dying, other half pregnant. Clinger, aren't you ashamed of yourself?
Yes, sir. I don't deserve to be in the army.
Chanting, two! Go for two! This will be a booth review to make sure that Wolfolk cross the plane of the goal line. This is essentially a free timeout for Army as well.
Yeah, he's across the line, he's never down, and they get a free timeout, so, and a chance to rest. So now they can make the decision about whether it's a two-point play or we kick the extra point.
How do you go about this process with still 18 seconds on the clock, but two wins in, you fail, you're probably losing this game?
I'm Jeff Munkin. I'm the best in the country on short yardage. I go for two.
You go for two.
I can't stop Rashad Penny if I get into overtime, and he's going to touch it every other time. So I believe in my offense. I believe in my quarterback. He's the leading rusher in the country. I'm the best at short yardage in the country. They're tired. We've got momentum. I'm going for two.
Definitive.
Yeah.
From Mac Brown.
No question. Easy from up here.
Sometimes easier from up here. No, that. Again, the ruling on the field was a touchdown. Wolfolk was on top of several offensive players when he crossed the plane.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Touchdown.
What do you think is going to get in the end zone? And that's what you do. He's talking to him right now. You trust your quarterback. What do you want to go for? What do you want to take? Let's go for it. What do you? Okay, offensive lineman, what do you think now? Man, this is a ball game. We got to score. Let's get our best play. What is it?
Well, as soon as we're done here in Fort Worth, Texas, we got another great bowl game on our ESPN triple header. Don't forget, Appalachian State Toledo is coming up next. San Diego State used a timeout as well to talk about their defensive setup.
What a game these two teams have given us.
This has been awesome. Santa's enjoyed it too.
It's a gift.
Well, we'll see. It's a bit of a gift for all of us, my friend. Here we go.
Yeah, anybody who says there's too many bowls hasn't been to one, and they're not watching this one.
Army down by one. For two of the lead with 18 seconds to go.
I think they put it in the quarterback's hand with a loaded option.
Walker to the edge for the lead.
Ran the week.
What a call, what a play, what a gutsy call. Good job. Now, we've been here before with 18 seconds left in the half, and we kicked it off to Penny, and he scored. Or Washington, I think, with Penny leading. So, you're right. I don't let anybody touch this one.
If you're going to beat me, you got to beat me with a big play to get into field goal range.
We were in the Rose Bowl against Michigan. Every time we kicked it to them, Preston was returning them about 50, 60, 70 yards, and I said one time, kick it out of bounds. Don't let him touch it. He said, well, they'll get it at the 35. And I said, oh, my gosh, what a break.
Yeah, for us. Steve Preston, one of the great return men in the history of college football. So Penny and Washington, who have combined for 10 kickoff return touchdowns in their career, are both back to return for San Diego State. Penny has tied the FBS record with his 7. San Diego State, with these two back there, have 10 combined.
So we know they're not touching.
So, if I'm Blake Wilson, rather Nick Schrag is out there now this time, not Blake Wilson. They're going to bring their punter out there for the kickoff.
Well, and you have to kick it far enough, you don't want them to have a Hail Mary shot.
So you've got to get into field goal range.
Shot to get into field goal range. You've got to kick it deep enough, but keep it out of your fast guys' hands. They've got Washington in the middle and Penny deep. I kick it to a tight end.
Towards the sideline, it is grabbed inbounds by Washington. And there goes Jawan Washington. Touchdown saving tackle by Riley. 40-yard line, still 12 seconds remaining, and one timeout for San Diego State.
That was one of those I was about to say, no, let me go out of bounds. I said, oh, no, good job.
That was a no. Yes, that was that type of play.
What a tackle by Riley. Best cornerback makes the play of the game right there. Now, long pass and field goal shot. Still got time.
Hit a 50-yarder in his career, a 43-yarder this year. So you get to about the 25 or 30, you might be in his field goal range.
This game is not over. They're playing man, one free high. They're coming after him.
Chapman under pressure, flips it forward, incomplete.
And there's nobody there. You've got to take a shot, hope for a Hail Mary, and hope for a miracle to happen.
Here we go.
Back it up, Army.
Yep. Could be the final play of the Armed Forces Bowl. We go underneath. Hook and lateral. Time has expired. Here is Chapman. Gonna have to sling it across the field. It is taken away by Riley. Army wins. Thank you. Fort Worth, Texas. An incredible game. And Army has a 10-win season for just the second time in its long history behind Ahmad Bradshaw. Tonight's Capital One player of the game. 180 rushing yards, 2 touchdowns, and his head coach, Jeff Bucket, is with Paul Carcaterra on the field.
Coach, this game was amazing. You went for 2. You decided with conviction to roll the offense out right away. Why?
Well, I think they were going to set a world record for yards per play. I mean, that Penny kid, what a player. And I just felt like we needed to win it in regulation. I didn't want to give him a chance to get the ball back again.
Describe the biggest challenge facing Rashad Penny. His 200 yards, 5 games in a row, that's a national record.
He's an incredible player. We're very fortunate to win the game. We did a bunch of things, especially on special teams, that could have hurt us. But, you know, our guys just kept believing, found a way, made some plays, and came out with a victory. Unbelievable. Just so proud of our team.
You know, Coach, you took this program from the bottom now. Only the second 10-win season in program history. Seniors like Ahmad Bradshaw. Describe what they've meant to this program.
The leadership that this senior class has provided for this program, unreal. Just the trust and the commitment and the love that they've had for these guys on this team to represent West Point and our United States Army. Just incredible. I couldn't be more proud of them. They're a great group of guys. We're going to miss them.
Amazing effort. Congratulations.
Thanks a lot. Beat Nate.
Classic to finish it with Beat Nate, which they've done 2 consecutive years. After losing 14 straight, they took home the Commander-in-Chief's Trophy for the first time in over 2 decades, and for just the second time in its program's history, going back to 1890, Army has a 10-win season. For Max